possible. You don't like to.
Yep.
There's some players who play challenge matches where they just play with the rest. I guess you wouldn't be very good in a match like that, would you?
No, maybe I should start practicing that.
That was a far miss.
Did she try a double kiss?
No, she didn't try that.
I was wondering.
Definitely not.
Yeah. Guy Young Kim likes a shot at this five.
Good. She avoided to hit both balls, but I think she played a little too soft. And she snookered herself here.
Second unforced error.
Wow, is she going to jump that one? That's a little surprise.
She can lose this cue ball off the table, right?
Yeah, exactly. Oof.
Gets a legal shot, but it's going to show for Taipei Chen.
But she still left it quite tough. And she tied up to 9-10 a little bit. I don't know if it's... I think it's the quarter pocket, the left lower quarter pocket still open, though, for it. And, of course, one side pocket, too.
Well, that's a far miss, but she thinks she has insurance right here. Possible jump shot again, or she has a two-rail kick.
Six side. Yep, that's a two-rail kick here.
So she has called the six into which side pocket?
Into the left.
The left, okay.
All right. But the thing is, if she gets behind the six properly, she might scratch in the lower left corner pocket. It's a tricky shot here. No, she hit it perfect.
Wow. She called the side and said...
Wow.
She did call the side?
Yeah, she called the
side. Oh, I thought the corner.
No, she called the side.
I was figuring how thin she would have hit that one, so she did call the side.
Yes, she did.
I think I saw you play that, but it went three rails in one of the... on YouTube, I think.
Well...
You have yourself on YouTube a lot, so...
Just going to say, can't remember every shot I played.
Guy Young Kim with a little bit of magic, and this shot's almost as good as the last one.
Yep,
good safety.
She came with two great shots back to back.
Yeah. Thing about a two-rail shot like the one that she sank is that, you know, she knows that the chances of her making it aren't that great, but she might as well call it. And then she got fortunate, got the perfect shot on the six.
Well done.
Did she call this?
No, I don't think so.
But
now she wishes she should have called it. That's why.
But she called it, but not in that pocket.
Not in bucket. But you know, we've been watching this for a whole week, and you know, unlike the men tend to call a pocket.
Well, although, she did too.
Yes, but most probably here the women usually say safety instead.
Yep.
Which you know.
It's not the smartest idea.
Yeah.
Because nothing to win. There's no reason
exactly.
to call safety.
Yeah. Unless, you know... No, there's not really a reason to call safety.
Yeah.
Unless there's, you know, like one or two open pockets. And then, you know, instead of getting in trouble, because the referee may thought that you were going for it. And
yeah.
But in general, there's no...
There's no reason.
No reason, no sense to call a safety.
Guy Young Kim had the option to give the shot back to Taipei Chen, and she did. And Taipei Chen plays a containing safe. Interesting decision by Guy Young. Cue ball behind the 10.
Yes, that's a spin, but it did not. But still, will get behind the 9.
Okay.
It's still good enough. Not as ideal as she wanted it to be, because you know she wanted to get the cue ball behind the 10. But you can't even kick one rail.
So it's really a lockout then.
Yeah.
She gets it behind there.
She called it in the left side pocket.
Yeah, 10 ball's gonna hang around there. This is a very interesting rack we're seeing here. Rack number four.
I wonder if she has to break up the 10-9 or if she can actually
bang
it or even play it without trouble. It's kind of hard to tell from here.
Or she can do that.
Now we know she needed to open him up.
Or does she play the 10 for the top? She has a. She can draw this.
Yeah, but not left-handed. I don't think she can draw it with a regular shot because.
Oh.
Here we go. Yeah.
Here comes the. Wow! Great shot.
Oh, a shot from Dayan Kim. No, going deep into the playbook for that one.
Well, for one, she doesn't have the tummy that you have, Ralph. So she can actually do that at ease.
I'm not so sure I'm going to try that shot anytime soon. Yeah,
that's going to break something in your bone, Bob.
Yeah. 10 ball is down for Dayan Kim. She takes a 3-1 lead, and we will return with more action after this short break here at the Allen Women's World 10 Ball Championship. Welcome back here at the Women's World 10 Ball Championship presented by Yalin and Ralph Suquet. Dayan Kim is playing well, but it's still early days in this match.
Yeah, absolutely. But what a great shot we've seen just before. And you could see her three cushion background there when she went up for the almost Marseille looking shot and drew that cue ball back. It was great.
Yeah, Korea, of course, is a country where they play a lot of three cushion billiards, and they have to play those funky shots, don't they?
Yep.
Do you play? Do you have any background at all in three cushion billiards?
No. Even though I have a lot of friends that are actually really, really good three cushion players, world champion team, like Martin Horn, Christian Rudolph, but I never really had a chance to practice with them.
Are you good friends with like Raymond Kuhlemans and Torbjörn Blomdahl?
I'm very good friends. Well, very good friends, but I know Torbjörn quite well. He lives in Germany, and we're actually supposed to do a training session together.
Torbjörn Blomdahl.
I'm very good friends. Well, very good friends, but I know Torbjörn quite well. He lives in Germany, and we're actually supposed to stage, but the fact that I'm never back home, never in Germany, we just didn't have the time yet to do that.
Of course, the great Sang Lee from Korea, the great three-cushion player, the late great Sang Lee, one of the many top Korean players. Actually, Efren Reyes is representing the Philippines in three-cushion in the Southeast Asian Games.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Hope he can snare a medal there.
Efren is a really, really good three-cushion player. I know that.
Yeah.
I remember once when he was playing challenge match with Torbjörn Blomdahl, and where Efren beat Torbjörn in three cushion, but Torbjörn beat Efren in nine ball.
How about that?
Okay.
That was odd.
Back to her main table. Dayan Kim has broken and has found herself with a shot here on the red three.
Wow.
Nice shot.
Now, I'm thinking, kiss four off to the thing. Yeah, she's calling it.
She called it right away.
She's starting to play quickly, isn't she, B-Boy? And that's not a good sign for Chai Pei Chen.
Oh, not at all.
She needs to hit this ball really hard in order to make it into the side. It needs to kind of bump off. Yeah. She didn't hit it hard enough. That's why it bubbled.
And she didn't call the nine. You can't call two balls in the WPA rules 10 ball.
She didn't really leave an open shot here. I don't know if she can see the five ball full enough in order to play a stop shot and leave the cue ball behind the 8 and 10 and just send the five ball down. From here it looks like if the cameraman would go a little over, we would have a little better view on that one.
She's calling the 5-10 combination.
10 in the side?
Okay.
Trying to go for a combination. This will be something else. I don't think there's any safety component in this. This is a full-blooded shot at this 10.
Needs to graze that 10 and does not go. the five track gang, and she
got lucky.
Be safe here.
She got lucky for it. But on the other hand, you know, Kim Ga-young was a little lucky on her missed five ball and left her not too much. So you need a roll here and there, otherwise you're unable to win the match at all.
She misses the jump on the 10 ball. Has she gotten lucky as well? The six might prevent Chai Pei Chen from knocking this five in.
I think she only sees a small part of the five. I'm not sure if it's enough to play a good safety here or not. She would probably need to come hit the short rail and the long rail and then try. Oh no, she can't see it at all, looks like.
Wow, that's a big miss. That's a surprising miss. I think at this level, you've got to get kick shots like that.
Yeah, she forgot to play more spin on that ball. She was, you know, aiming to hit it, you know, with more spin. And trying to play the six in the right side and then the seven in the same pocket. Nice position play.
She looks really comfortable, you know, and she's just such a seasoned professional. Yesterday in her match with Erica Park, I mean, Erica came like 45 minutes before, started practicing, trying to get a feel of the table. Ga-young just saunters in 15 minutes before the match, and Ga-young won by a huge margin.
Yeah, I think 8-1 or so, or 8-2.
Oh, there we go. And you see her slam that cue on the table. Ouch.
I don't know if she actually needed to cheat the pocket there in order to create a better angle or a straight in position for the 10. That position could have been a little easier too.
She's got a scratch in the side pocket to worry about.
No, that should not be. But we almost missed that one.
A shocking miss from Ga-young Kim, and Chai Pei Chen pulls it within one. This is the Yalin Women's World 10 Ball Championship. Do check out yalin.cn. It is the website of our title sponsor, Yalin Billiards. And you can learn more information about this event at womensworld10ball.com. That's the number 10-10. womensworld10ball.com. And they are hanging from the rafters here in the upper levels of the atrium to get a vantage point from which to enjoy this wonderful spectacle of women's pool.
That was a huge unforced error there. Big difference between 4-1 breaking herself or 3-2 and having to watch your opponent break.
There wasn't a great deal to do with the position on the cue ball on that shot either.
Not really, no.
Might have just taken it for granted. And there's another unforced error. That cue ball goes hopping straight into that pocket.
And she made two balls with it. And the table looks quite nice and open.
That's just a miss hit. What are your philosophies in general, Ralph, when it comes to breaking in 10 ball? Is it vastly different from 9 ball breaking?
More or less, yeah. I like, or I prefer to break more from the center in 10 ball, you know, and try to make one of the two balls, you know, behind the one into the side pocket.
Yeah. Yep. I don't know if that's happening much in this tournament, is it?
Well, the thing is, if you have a wrecking device like the Magic Wreck or the Sardo Wreck used to be, or a template, then it's obviously a lot easier. And with the normal wooden wreck, if the balls are not tight, or not all of them are really, really tight, then it's much, much more difficult to make one of these two balls into the side.
And you just had to hit it as hard as you can and wait for something to come in somewhere.
Not necessary, but you know, sometimes it's good to switch to the side, as most players prefer in nine ball, and try to either make the one into the side pocket, or maybe one of the two corner balls go in four rails and into the lower corner pockets.
There's really more of a science to it than we think, isn't there?
Yeah, it is.
And we see on
and
TV.
It's still the most important shot of the whole match, or of the whole game.
Extension here, a cue extension. Now those extensions, they like change the balance of your cue, don't they, Ralph?
They do, but you know, it's there's no way out. You actually have to have it, unless you want to play with the
bridge a lot.
And of course, former snooker players, they are so good with the bridge. It's unbelievable, and I really admire them for that.
Guy Young going to the opposite side of the eight ball.
Well, landed perfectly there.
This is going to be good for confidence.
Well, that makes it 4-2. Her breaking in rec 7.
Guy Young Kim pulls one back after the error. This is the Yalin Women's World 10 Ball Championship. We'll take a short break when we return. Rack number 7. Stay right here on Studio 23.
Here, rack number 6. Guy Young Kim to break. And Tsai Pei Chen must try and solve the problem of how to control herself. She has been losing control and scratching off the break. Guy Young Kim, however, has been finding stride. Two ball, three ball down, and no shot on the one.
Guy Young Kim seems to have found a formula here for the break. He has two dry breaks in the first two racks, but bounced back well off the break.
But she still hasn't got a good shot or a good opportunity after the break.
So she was first going to go for the shot, then she changes her mind. That's legal. You can also retract the push out. You can take up, say you play push out and take it back. I saw Alex Pagulayan do that once, and when Michaela Tab was the referee.
So yeah, of course you're allowed to do that.
Yep.
No, it's not a touch move like in a chess, so.
Yeah. Tsai Pei Chen, safety opportunity.
And that's too weak.
Wow, that is just nowhere near the speed she needed on that one ball.
Yeah, she doesn't seem to be in the game. Still not in there. I mean, she's, you know, struggling with the break, coming short on safeties. And
Boo almost going in. Still some issues here. That 8 and 9 has to find a way to try and fix that.
That 8 and 9 is really an insurance policy, isn't it, to prevent a run out. That little.
Yeah, it's definitely not open.
Yeah, that guy created off the push out.
I wonder what she has in mind with the 7 ball, because that's going to be the main problem here. She could maybe play the 6 in the upper right corner and try to break up that cluster there.
And hold for the 7 at the same time.
But it's not really you can't really hold it. It's still going to be a tricky shot afterwards. That was no good.
She's really, you know, she's really struggling, I think, with the speed of this table.
She hit that ball way too full to begin with. That's why it shortened it up so much.
Sixth and fourth error for Chai Pei Chen against three for Ga-young Kim.
And that's a lot. And only seven racks.
Yeah.
Not even finished yet, yeah. Seven racks.
Considering that Ga-young only has a two-rack lead.
Well, they both made some mistakes. You know, Ga-young made that unforced error where she missed it. Easy eight ball. So she gave one back.
That's gonna show.
And she nudged the nine out from here. She might end up scratching. So.
Yeah, no, I don't think the angle's on for that.
No, it's definitely not.
She can scratch intentionally if she wanted to, but I don't think she's got the angle to go off the short rail, just short of that pocket into the 10. I don't think that's on.
Into the 9, you mean?
Yeah. Oh, that six ball stays up. Ga-young is not happy.
Now there's actually a chance for Chai to, you know, play the six and let the cue ball run into the 9 to open up that problem there. Oh, she
almost
missed it. She missed it. And you can tell by her expression that she is not happy.
Did she have to hit it at that speed?
She needed to hit it hard, because if she would have hit it too soft, then the cue ball might have been stayed just behind the 9 and she would have snookered herself. So the speed was good, no doubt about that. She just, you know, overcut it a little bit.
She was asking a lot of the cue ball on that shot.
Yeah.
Asking
but she had
a lot. Yeah. Well, she could have, you know, maybe she could have played, just leave the cue ball there and then try and play safe on the 8. But she loaded that one up with all sorts of left-hand English, and that's why she missed it.
But that wasn't really a good option to play safety off the 8, to be honest, you know. Mm-hmm. From the angle we're looking at right now, it looks impossible, but when you look from a further distance, then it seems to be a possibility to make the 8 in the lower left corner. I'm not sure if the 8 ball is frozen or if it's a little off. That we can't really tell from here.
She's calling it.
But she kind of has to punch the ball too in order to get a position for the 9. So it's a little off, we can see it right now. So that makes it slightly easier.
Oops.
It's a tough one.
Yeah.
It was a tough one, definitely.
I'm not sure this 8 passes into the side pocket. I don't think it does. So Ga-young Kim will be lucky here.
She might be able to play a safety and duck the cue ball behind the 9. Or maybe even play the 8 in the sides. But I'm not sure.
She's ducking.
Yep. One, yeah.
That's safety I like.
That was a good one, yeah. Yeah, she was going to hit one rail.
Eight ball. Corner.
Try to hit the 8 face on and bank the 8 off the long rail into the upper right corner.
A kick bank here.
Yep.
Obviously, luck will play a big factor in the
or
upper.
Or maybe double kick, depending on. No, yeah, that's what I figured.
Make a Z shot. Okay.
She hit it actually quite well. Just a little unlucky on the on the speech judgment here.
This is a big win for Chai Pei Chen. This will pull her to within 1.
ball, corner.
Yeah, she played that nine ball with so-called pocket speed. She cheated the pocket, but she played it with the right speed so that the nine ball still has a chance to slide in off the rail.
And ball is down for Chai Pei Chen. She won two of the last three, and she trails by just one rack. We've got a real game on here in our second semifinal at the Yalin Women's World 10 Ball Championship. Do find out, do look for us on Facebook, ABS, the official ABS-CBN Sports page on Facebook, and there's, of course, ABS-CBN Sports on Twitter. Get more updates and news and results of all of the great sporting events that are being covered on ABS-CBN Sports. There's a look at what these ladies are playing for the trophy, and of course, $20,000 for our winner, $9,000 for our runner-up, and today's semifinal losers, $5,000. It's Peter Musni on the left, the head of ABS-CBN Sports, and Eric Ding on the right from Yalin Billiards, and there's Rubelin Binkai Amit from Mandawi, Cebu. She fell last night to Chai Pei Chen in a real thrilling match. She had to make a table-length bank on the 9. Got perfect shape on the 10 to force final rack decider. And in the final rack decider, she broke dry. And Chai Pei Chen ran out all 10 balls. Never let Binkai shoot again.
Yep.
It was unbelievable atmosphere last night.
Close. I mean, there were two balls where the... I can't remember exactly. It was the 10 that bobbled, and I think the 5 ball.
One. Yes, yeah.
Another time deciding where to go in. Successful break here. But, no, she didn't leave anything here. It was even tough to find a spot for a halfway decent push-out here.
Push-out.
No, I'm just checking if the 1-9 is on, but I don't think so.
No. It's not on, but with the correct angle on it, you could play the 1 into the rail and then off the rail and make the 9, but obviously not from this side there.
How about just giving it back?
If the one ball is frozen, which it looks like, I would probably give it back because you would have to hit the one ball so thin in order to not double kiss with the cue ball.
Well, she's following your advice.
Yep.
It's a case of return to sender here for Gayang Kim.
I'm not sure what she has called here.
I think she's called the 9 ball. She didn't call that.
Okay. Interesting. That she now called two ball corner. I don't know
she
what that
was just making a joke.
Where did that come from?
Chai Pei Chen going for the safety and overhitting that. What do you like here, B-Boy?
Another safety. The 10 is too high up to play the combination. I don't know. The billiard, I don't think, is going to be available. So
that looks too difficult. I think she's going to duck the cue ball behind the 9 if she can see enough of the 2, which appears.
And it's going to pop out and shot on the side. And this is not good for Gayang.
Well,
this rack to tie it up.
I wonder if it's still in Kim Gayong's mind that she lost her last match in the group stages, 6-1, to Tsai Pen Chen.
That's what I did say at the very start. She only lost once in this entire tournament, and this is to this woman. When the Tsai Pei Chen just demolished her, 6-1.
And as I said before, I wonder if that's still in her mind, if that comes into play here and there.
But I don't really think so, because she started off firing at the rack, and it's just now that she's been slowing down.
Well, that's how it goes sometimes, You may not want to think about it, but then when things are not going the way you want,
you get flashback.
Yeah, exactly.
And that plainly goes for the side, comes out for the 9. option for the side or corner.
Well, I think the six only goes into the side, to be honest. Well executed here.
Perhaps a little bit too much angle on the six. Perhaps she preferred to be straight on the six into the side, but
yeah,
but not gonna bother her too much. It's in and out.
I don't know if she can just follow through and let the cue ball go to the short rail, and I'm not sure why she actually drew it a little bit. You know?
Just follow it with a bit of left-hand English?
Should be stunned, I guess.
A little right-hand English.
Right-hand.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But don't put any draw into it, you know. That's why
she's got such a big angle now.
Yeah, exactly.
Otherwise, some players tend to think that when you're drawing the ball, you're trying to slow it down. So maybe, you know, you're trying to apply brakes.
Mm-hmm. But then she would have had to play it with inside English, with left English, in order to come back
and a kill
closer
stroke
to the seven.
Well, you got to show me how to, so I understand better.
Okay.
Because there are some shots that this man can play that we don't even understand.
But a great shot on the seven ball here.
This one I can understand fully.
Jai Bashan showing a lot of character right now.
And she's back in the match. She's going to tie it up at four here.
And Gayan King cannot let this pretty young lady get on stride if she is. She is going to have problems like she already knew in the early part of this tournament. This 10 ball to tie things up.
Chai Pei Chen has taken three of the last four. And we have ourselves a game here. We'll be back for rack number nine after this short break. Has she made anything? The answer would be no.
Nope. And again, she does not leave any shot whatsoever.
Isn't it amazing in pool? Like some matches are just so offensive. All the break is always such a good scatter, and some they just, you know, trench warfare.
Yep.
Like walking through sand sometimes, you know.
Like a real battle. Yep.
Yes.
Right from the start. Yep.
Attritional safety battle. Gayan Kim pushing out. B-Boy, is there any reason for Chai Pei Chen to go for this long one?
I don't like offensive. Well, going offensive here. I would prefer the safety, bring that one ball all the way to where the 9, 10, 7 are. Just if she has to, she come back.
I wouldn't like the offensive part either, because you don't really get any rewards. Because the cue ball is going to, you know, get off the three and going towards the right side of the table, and you know, even separate it more from the two.
She can also play that one into that cluster there, the nine, just crossed the one ball then.
First of all, she gave it back, which was not a bad decision to begin with. Yeah,
Gayan here now can do that shot right there, and
well played.
Containing shot there.
Yeah, she did quite well here. We're probably looking at a two-rail kick shot here. Hit the long rail first, then the short rail, and then, you know, come from behind to cut the one ball in. Even if she hits it a little too full, it will separate both balls.
But she's got to call it. I don't know if she's called
it. She did. Yeah, she did already. Okay. Yeah. And she hit it perfect.
Oh, beautiful. Wow.
Perfect hit. Yeah.
Speaking about perfect, I just got a slight message from Charlie Williams saying that they're going to win the Moscone Cup this year. What do you think about that, Ralph?
Well, let him dream. It's okay.
Fighting talk from Ralph Suke. The Moscone
Cup.
Don't
worry, we are ready for it.
Moscone, of course, the USA versus Europe. That's held every year. This year it's in Las Vegas. And Johan Reising's going to be your coach again?
Yes, absolutely.
And I guess you would have a lot of confidence in him.
Yes, I mean, he's a great coach to begin with. You know, he really knows how to cheer us up and cheer us on. You know, I mean, he's such a great coach.
USA will be led by, is it going to be Nick Varner again, or you don't know?
Well, I heard rumors that Nick Varner didn't want to do the job for whatever reason. Mm-hmm. And I think that, you know, his substitute could be Charlie Williams.
Oh,
wow. That I'd love to see. Ga-young Kim off the great safety from Chai Pei Chen. She jumps and she's left the two ball on for the young lady from Chinese Taipei.
Wow, the four all scoreline, the match turner there. She managed to break up that 7-10 off of that safety as well. Nothing to do here but just apply a little bit of draw so she won't be hampered by that five. Or she can slightly follow this. That's a great shot. And just draw back for the four, then the five in the opposite lower corner.
You know, I liked your suggestion, B-Boy, to follow this one, to get away from the five. She's got the hampered queuing now on the three.
Not and you can see her. she's stroking much better now, and she's walking around the table faster.
She has her confidence.
Yeah.
I saw in the qualifier, she's a very fast, she's not really fast player, but she's a rhythm player. And when she gets going, it's actually scary how good she can play.
Yeah. I mean, that's how I've seen her playing. But, you know, it's always different when you make it to the, you know, TV stages in the further stages. You know, when it's sometimes a little easier in playing the preliminaries than, you know, making it to the quarters, semis and finals. Because then you're obviously playing for titles and, you know, also for, you know, a little more money.
You can play loose a bit in the other stages.
Yeah. Not saying that you underestimate, you know, opponents or just the fact that it's in early stages. But, you know, in this kind of format, round robin, in the very first stage, you know, you kind of, you know, you should get more chances, even if you blew a few here and there, then you usually get a chance to, you know, fight back.
Yeah.
But here, and when you make it to the knockout stages, it's do or die.
No margin for error.
Yeah.
Chai Pei Chen is motoring through this rack. She's gonna take her first lead in the match, it seems.
Here we go. She's starting to shoot great. Not still perfect, but this last two balls for the lead. It's a race to nine. Our second semifinals. Kelly Fisher of Great Britain waiting on the wings.
There goes another 10 ball for Chai Pei Chen. 5-4. She leads this match. At stake of birth in the finals of the Yellen Women's World 10 Ball Championship. This event, of course, sanctioned and supported by the World Pool Billiard Association. Title sponsor, of course, Yellen Billiards. There's plenty at stake here, guys.
Yeah, champion gets $20,000. Nine to the fourth placers, all the way to the fifth and sixth placers in the group stages. So everybody gets something, which is not bad.
Yeah,
Ralph. I mean, this is pretty good prize money even for the men, isn't it?
Yeah, that's a pretty good breakdown. Even though I'm not a big fan of cutting or going down like from 20,000 to less than 50%. I personally don't agree with that, but that's my personal opinion, obviously. I rather like to see it like whatever, if it's 20, maybe 12 or 13 for second.
Yeah.
Because, you know, it's nice enough, in my opinion, to win a world title.
Yes.
And of course, you know, it's nice to get some money with it, but, you know, if you finish runner-up, which is also a very good achievement, and you kind of have to sell it for less than 50%, it hurts a lot, you know.
You've been there, I guess.
Yep, I've been there many, many times. But luckily, I've also been on the other side, where I was able to, you know, cash the big ones.
You won a world championship, I want to say 1996, is that right?
Yep.
World 9 ball, and then you won an 8 ball, when was that?
2008.
At least one US Open.
Yep. Well, one in nine ball and one in straight pool.
Yes, that's right.
You only won a straight pool?
Yes. I'm still actually the defending champion because I didn't have a US Open since.
Never played
believe it
again.
Or not, 2000.
Oh, okay.
You're like Dennis Orkulju and the World Pool League. Dennis Orkulju is going to be the champion of the World Pool League forever.
Forever, yeah.
Because they never played it again after he won it.
And it's the same with Rodolfo Luat. I think he won once the Camel Nine Ball World Championship or so, yeah. And obviously, we all know that Camel no longer is doing any pool events. Well, back to the game here. We have a tricky table where almost all the balls are on the right side of the table, except for the two ball. And I'm not really sure what she was trying to do here. Maybe double bank the one and maybe play the safety.
Maybe complete that line of balls. I think that's what she was trying to do. Make it a drill, perhaps. I think that was the plan.
That's what it looks like here. It looks like a drill. Yeah. Except that the order is a bit out of order.
Shoot the four, draw it, shoot the five, draw it, shoot the... It's like a draw shot drill.
You know what? I think Gaia might be thinking of banking the two ball in here instead of cutting this in. What do you think? Oh, she's going to cut it in.
Oh, she's going to cut it in, yeah.
From here, this is, well, one of these shots of this rack when she has to deal with the rest. We're all lined up.
Well, she needs a perfect position on the four to get a perfect angle on the five. And then the tricky part is to get a good shape on the six.
She didn't hit this cue ball hard enough. She's got a big angle on the four.
Because the six is really the tricky ball here.
So will she be playing one pocket here?
She has to.
She has to, yes.
I guess Efren would like this scenario here.
Well, there goes
that was the thing, you guys. Big miss there.
Yeah, she gave herself too much angle in that four, didn't she?
Yeah.
The stakes are starting to creep into the game of Gai Young Kim. That continent's perhaps being eroded just a bit.
Well, honestly, that was a tough line there, right there.
It was, yeah. And to be honest, I haven't seen such a lineup in 30 years of playing.
That's the wonderful thing about pool. I mean, every rack is completely different, completely unique.
Yeah.
It's like if you're a golfer and you go to your golf course and it's a brand new golf course every single day. I mean, that's how pool is.
I just remember the same tree I land on every time.
Yep.
Wow, that is a shot right there. She needs that to stop, and she stops perfect.
Yeah.
This is getting really scary now here for this girl from Korea. Girl from Taipei is shooting almost lights out.
The momentum shift is really pronounced, isn't it?
And it's really a big oomph.
Diane Kim led 3-1. 4-2, and she missed three balls in rack number 7. She had a weak save in the rack number 8. She missed a four ball in this rack. And to put that all together, and Taipei Cheng is three balls away from leading 6-4.
The big, not saying swing, but the big ball was when she missed that 8 ball.
Yeah.
I think at 3-1 to go up 4-1.
She missed it in rack number 5. She was up 3-1, and she was going to go 4-1. She missed it
exactly.
To 3-2.
And that was a huge mistake. Because leading 4-1 and breaking, or just 3-2 and your opponent is breaking on a winner's break form.
Big difference.
Oh, big difference, yeah.
And you may think that angle's big. She's just right on target, just has to go back down for that cue ball, shoot the 10 in the side pocket. Yeah, two rack advantage coming up here.
There goes another 10 ball for Taipei Chen. 6-4 she leads, four racks in a row. We will be back after this short break for rack number 11.
matapang.
Ikaw ay hindi lang tagapaghatid ng impormasyon.
Panig sa katotohanan.
Ikaw ay tutulong din sa mga manonood.
Mapagkakatiwalaan.
Kredibilidad ng isang reporter ay nadadaan din sa kanyang karanasan at lalong-lalo na sa kanyang maingat na pagtrato sa mga storya at sa balansing pagtrato sa mga issue.
Batikan at respetadong mamamahayag ng ABS-CBN.
Ako si Tony Velasquez para sa Ibabalita Ngayon.
Ibabalita Ngayon! Monday to Friday, 11 a.m. sa Studio 23. Iba! Kabarkada!
Trying to shoot, actually.
Might be thought of a sharking.
Yeah, a little bit. No, I mean, she took a timeout for like 5 minutes, and she could have, or she should have done it then, to be honest.
Well, I'm not going to argue with that. Did not try to go fully for the ball, but has left it on.
That's a real one pocket shot there, isn't it?
She actually made the right decision, try to bank the two and, you know, get the cue ball down table. And if she misses the two ball, then it's probably going to stay at the end rail. But she double kissed with it, and that's why the complete outcome was different. That gives Kim Ga-young a chance here to get back into the game.
That one rattles in. A nice kiss off the nine. Mm-hmm. She appreciates that. But this shot's not a gimme, guys. Position for the four.
Yeah, it's a little tricky. Because now that the nine is basically in the way, she has to kind of get in between the nine and the four. I don't know if she can just hold it there. Yeah, that's what I figured. But very well played, actually.
Yeah,
even though she's on top of the eight, yeah. But that should be not a big problem.
Take the long shot on the five.
I just wonder if the seven ball has a pocket at all. I'm quite sure that it doesn't go into the lower left. Yeah.
It's
now we
close.
Can see the
it's
yeah, but
close.
It's enough room there.
Interesting the way Ga-young played that. A lot of players would have just slow rolled it with the five. She's gone out of two rails and she's given herself a thinner cut on the five.
No, she actually did the right thing because she had too much angle on the four to just slow roll it. Otherwise, the cue ball would have ended very near to the upper left corner pocket.
Would have traced a left-hand English on that ball, I think, also.
Yeah.
Her speed needs to be perfect. That's good speed. That's a real champion shot right there. Those are the shots, really, that, you know, ordinary people won't appreciate how good that shot is.
Yeah, it was a great shot because if she comes like 2 inches shorter than that, then she needs to travel with the cue ball three rails in order to get back to this side to play the seven in the lower left corner.
And longer, she won't have the angle to land on the seven.
Exactly,
either.
Yeah. So a very delicate shot that was.
Well, if you've seen her yesterday play against Erica Park, you see how different her demeanor is.
This is going to be a good rack for Ga-young. I like her body language. She's got a purposeful air about her. She seems super focused and confident, and this will pull her back to within one.
That's the reason why she took a timeout before. You know, she wanted to get herself back into the game. You know, try to make sure to stay focused and forget all about the bad things that happened in the last five or six racks.
10 ball deposited for Ga-young Kim. She's sending a message to Chai Pei Chen that she's not going to be a pushover here. 6-5, the lady from Chinese Taipei leads Chai Pei Chen. Yalit Women's World 10 ball championship. Bob Guerrero, B-Boy Soriano, and Ralph Suke on the call. Glad you could join us here on Studio 23. Special presentation of ABS-CBN Sports and Dragon Promotion. This is how rack number 11 went down, and it was Ga-young Kim basically stamping her glass. running out to the 10th ball.
Yeah, she just tore this rack apart, basically.
I wasn't here for the players' meeting. Was it mentioned that the 10 ball has to be called? Like,
no, so as long as it's obvious. And
yeah, because all of the players seem to nominate the 10, even though if it's easy and straight in. I just wondered if that was mentioned. Or, you know.
I think it's a good rule where you don't have to nominate it if it's obvious.
Oh.
Because sometimes, you know, we've had in Challenge of Champions where balls that weren't called, nine balls that weren't called, and they had to give it back, you know.
Yeah.
Obviously, if it's an obvious shot, common sense should prevail.
I know, I mean, that's the official WPA rule, but I'm just saying, I mean, like in the Challenge of Champions...
They're so strict, they're too strict.
Yeah, the promoter actually says... I want the nine ball to be called, no matter if it's hanging or not.
No. Here it's not also.
Okay. I was just wondering if, you know, if Dragon Promotions maybe, you know, came up with the rule and said, make sure you're going to call the 10,
only
no matter.
Only banks, kicks, caroms.
Yeah, of course. I mean.
And the 10 ball, of course. So as long as it's obvious, no need to. But the women usually point at it as if, you know, they're used to it.
Okay.
Scratch on the break for Guy and Kim, a nasty bit of luck. And... Chai Pei Chen.
I think she
awkward queuing.
She, you know, placed the cue ball a bit straight for the one. You know, she would have liked a little closer to the two after she made the one.
Again, she awkward queuing, and had a lot to do with the cue ball. And she's really gotten away with murder on this shot. There, she misses the two and hooks Guy Young Kim. That's the eighth unforced error for Chai Pei Chen. Seven for Guy Young Kim.
Seven. Right corner.
Just gonna jump, which is tough to begin with because the distance between the cue ball and the four ball is short. And she's going for a combination here. Watch the cue ball. This time she got lucky.
No.
And she leaves nothing. I think she's actually corner hooked there. Even though seems like the 8 and 7 are in the way anyway, so.
Yeah. Corner hooked, jaw hooked. The English players call it being angled. That's the term in snooker. And Chai Pei Chen has to go for this on the one rail kick. Two rail kick. Good hit, but it's going to roll up her Guy Young.
Well, she hit that ball very, very well, but. Unfortunately, it got stopped by another ball and left it wide open for Kim Guy Young. And I think we have another game back on. Looks like a 6-6 here.
Yeah, it's going to be a virtual race to three after this.
The key shot here is 5-6. Got a smallish landing area for the six.
Yeah, she needs a good angle on the six in order to get, you know, good shape for the seven then, which means more or less as straight as possible, because she doesn't want to bump into the 10 after playing the six.
Oh, she's gonna get good shape here.
Watch out. Oh, I guess she has to. Oh, backhanded.
Do you hit the shot, Ralph?
To be honest, my back hurts too much. I can't even shoot that shot anymore. I used to do it when I was younger, but nowadays I can't do it no more.
I find it unbelievably hard to shoot straight when you're shooting behind the back. I don't know how the pros do it. I really don't.
Ask me, I'll teach you.
I'd rather learn other billiard skills than that. There are more basic ones I have to learn.
But it definitely looks great on television, that's for sure.
And back on track.
That came slightly short. No, I think she's okay. She can just draw it back and avoid to hit the 10.
I think Guy Young Kim is showing a lot of character here, playing the way she's playing. Fighting back, although she's given herself a little bit of work to do here on this 10. Dai Young Kim is showing the heart and grit of a true champion. Back-to-back runouts means she is tied up with Chai Peichen 6-all. This is the Yalin Women's World 10-Ball Championship. Studio 23. It's come down to a virtual race to three. Just a reminder that our final will be played right after the conclusion of this match. Kelly Fisher is waiting there after she won her first semi-final against Yu Han. Dai Young Kim was the finalist last year, losing finalist. She'd love to make it three finals in a row.
Yeah, right now she's looking better again.
You have to come out with, say, your opponent sensed you were having problems, so she composed herself, then she gave back her nerve. And this now, Chai Peichen must be a bit nervous again, I guess.
Yeah, she made a ball on the break.
Seven ball is down.
And she has a combination 1-2 on here.
She actually made the ball, a second row ball into the side pocket,
yeah,
which we haven't been seeing much at all.
The problem here is, I think, you know, making the two ball is not that difficult, but the position for the one ball, that's the tricky part. And that's what makes the combination hard again.
And
three ball combination?
I don't know about that.
But she hit it at speed, at separation. I mean, she did play it right, I think.
But it's actually a good option. Because
I would play it. Five. I would play it.
The thing is, the one ball will probably hit the six. I mean, it goes off the five, most likely into the six, and then it might stay there. But if it passes the six, then I don't know.
So meaning that if she gets this and hits this perfectly, she might have a shot on the one for the opposite side pocket or the corner.
If she hits it thin enough, then she will pass the six ball. Then she needs to make sure that the cue ball goes down table too, otherwise she won't have a shot on the one ball, you know. That's the tricky part here again.
It's a three ball combo.
She will have a shot here.
Yeah, but she tied up the three and the five.
And now,
not a whole lot she could do about that.
A good shot there on that three ball combination. No,
that looks ugly now.
Well, yes it does. No shot here, but to just draw this, not to force it. Is she going to force this one or play this in the side? No. Yeah, safety.
Safety, yeah.
That
That's
is smart.
Smart.
No positional value. Well, so play safe.
Tyson's going to try and contact this without leaving a shot there to break that 5-3 up. Doesn't have to really force the issue.
Oh, sheesh. I don't know if calling. Well, of course you can call it, but I think her goal actually is to just slice the one, just, you know, barely hit it, leave it there, and bring the cue ball down table again. Oh no, she had totally different things in mind here.
She trusted the luck there, didn't she? I think that's one of the things that some of the players at the standard, you know, the kicking is, it's not just hitting the balls and trusting luck. Sometimes if you hit the right side of the ball, you can do some damage.
Yeah.
Put some more thought in it. And she's, you know, she's given Guyang a great chance to break up the cluster.
I think she still has too much angle for that. I don't think she's able to.
Okay.
Safety.
But now there is a chance to play safety because, you know, the two balls to height.
She didn't get there, did she?
Yeah, she got there.
Oh, she got there.
I think that's a good shot, yeah.
Open.
Troy Dano checking if three ball is frozen to the rail. Because
if she can three, just a tiny bit of the three, which it seems to be the case, then she can actually play a resave here and bring the cue ball right back where it is.
And that's what she almost tried to do. Now,
Bank, of course, is not going to be available unless she scoops that three under. So safety again.
It's probably the same shot again. Try to clip the three on the right side. Maybe draw and try to get the cue ball behind that the 6 or 9 ball there.
Time is going to be too weak. But still, it's a containing save.
Yeah. Well, she wanted to make sure here to leave the 3 ball close to the end rail.
You know, I seem to get the impression that Gai Young is significantly better at safety than Chai Pei-Chen. I seem to get that impression this match.
Yeah, that's what it looks like.
You see it in this rack also.
This, of course, angle almost similar to the bank that Rublin missed last night. Of course, the 5 ball was in there, but...
Made last night, actually, you mean. The one that Rublin... Oh, the earlier one, yeah, that's right. Rublin tried 2 banks last night. Missed the first one, made the next one. And that was another
bad execution here.
It's like she didn't know what to do there.
I think the better option would have been, you know, to bring the 3 ball down table towards the 6 and 9 and try to duck the cue ball behind the 4.
That would need a kill shot. Needs a good draw shot here.
Boom.
This is shot. You know, this is the real Gai Young Kim. I mean, Gai Young was struggling in the middle part of this match, but she's coming up and playing shots that a lot of even top men players would have difficulty with. Not a lot of angle here on this 4.
I don't know if she can... is she following through or is she drawing? No, she's drawing back. Okay.
That is an impressive shot, reaching out like that and drawing that far. That is no picnic.
Well, the match shifted back and forth here. First it was Kim Gai-young, then
going
it was Chai Pei-chen.
Yeah, going up 3-1 and then Chai Pei-chen won 5 of the next 6 and now
to go up 6-4 and now it's
going to be 3 in a row for Gai-young. She misses that 6.
I cannot believe that.
That's a shocker.
You know, that was just playing it too quick for my in my opinion.
Maybe that's what it was, yeah.
Wow,
that is hard to believe.
It's an easy out. She just needs to get straight on the 9 off the 6.
Wow, that again is going to be a confidence booster and a possible game changer.
Well, maybe I'm jinxing the players here. Maybe I.
Well, at least it's equal.
Yeah, we're all jinxing everybody.
Wow.
10 ball.
I'm not giving this bracket.
She can just slow roll this in, really. Make the pocket nice and big. Just like that, Chai Pei-chen has retaken the lead after another shocking miss from Gai-young Kim. 6 ball stays on the table when everybody thought it was going to go down easily. 7-6, Pei-chen. Chai is in command and is breaking to get on the hill here at the Women's World 10 Ball Championship. Our final follows Kelly Fisher waiting for the winner of this match. 3rd running of this event, a special presentation of ABS-CBN Sports and Dragon Promotions.
Strap number 14, chin to break, leading 7 rounds to 6.
Strong break, but a dry one.
Not really a strong break. The ball didn't really move that much.
Cue ball did go up in the air a bit, but it's a dry break. It's the 2nd dry break for Chai Pei-chen. And Gai-young has to convert now to get back on track.
It's quite an open table. Problem is the six ball here. It does not really have, you know, an open pocket.
Yeah, it all depends on the five.
The 6-8 combo, which is tough. 6-10 combo, which is also tough. And there's, you know, maybe the left side pocket might be in play.
But you have to get on the upside of the table to take that and five it. Yeah. We'll see in a short while.
Yeah, well, position 5-6 is the key here.
She's going to take this in the side. That won't pass for the corner. Or maybe it does. Nope, it does not. Question now is, will she get to where she wants for the six?
I think she wanted to be a little straighter than that. So now she has to go in between the 10 and the 6. Just play it soft and try to get perfect angle on the 6 to play it in the right side pocket, which is really, really tough. Or to play maybe with inside English and try maybe to bump into the 8 and then create, you know, an angle to play the 6 in the upper left corner. But then you bump the 8 maybe to a place where you can't play the 8 no more. So it's a tricky one.
Ah. Whoa. How'd you get through there? I don't think she intended to bump into one of those balls, I guess.
Well, looks like she was going into the 9.
She's playing this quickly.
Safety, yeah. If she gets
behind, that's going to be. That line was seen right after she hit it.
But that's the problem when you play too fast. And she had plenty of time to check out the angle, even though it seemed like a very easy safety, but you know, there was enough room for the cue ball to go behind the 9 and go through.
Well, she went in between it, so the possibility for that cue ball to go the opposite way, and it did. Now, this rack lines up, if she takes it, lines up Saipei Chen to go on the hill.
Maybe we shouldn't say anything anymore. Just let him play.
The nerves of the
This is
moment.
Similar about to last night's match between Rublin and her. You know, Gaia, we did not see anybody come close to her match like this. I don't think she's played anybody that she's been, you know, coming close to like this nerves, but this is what we felt last night.
Wow, it looked like Kim Dae-young was, you know, giving it back for the second straight time, and Tsai Pei-chen just handed it back to her.
That's a nice control draw.
We're looking like a race to 2 here to make it to the championship match.
10 ball down for Gaia-young Kim. She'll be breaking for the hill. It's a seesaw battle. Gonna be very close and very tight here in our second semi-final of the Yaolin Women's World 10 Ball Championship. Both players definitely feeling the heat. Well, Ralph Suquet, you picked a good match to commentate with us. It's going to be very close, very tight.
Absolutely, yeah. Even though both players made a lot of unforced errors so far. But, you know, it's still a great match to watch, to commentate. You know, it's really tight, a lot of tension, both sides. And
strap, 13, Kim to break, the score is 7-all.
But it's actually good to see some mistakes here and there, because that shows the audience how tough this game can be and actually is. You know, when you only see easy runouts, then it feels like, you know, yeah, it's such an easy game. Everybody can do that. No, it's not. It's a very, very tough game.
Gaia-young Kim breaks dry, her third dry break of the match. And B-Boy Soriano, do you like Tsai Pei-chen's chances at a runout here?
I'll leave that up to Ralph.
Well, I'm, you know, not good with my prediction so far. Normally, I would say
yes,
it should be,
but
a good chance. The position now is crucial, from the 2 to the 3.
It's going between the 5 and the 9.
That's good speed.
Possibly play the 4 up right corner pocket.
Or maybe in the side, but the side looks, might be. Sometimes I prefer personally, you know, if it's like a road map where you can just play stop, 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 I rather take on a more difficult shot into the side, even though the pockets seem to be a little smaller, than try to get perfect shape to play it in the corner pocket. But, you know, obviously every player has different, different ideas and patterns and preferences, actually. That's what the word that I was looking for here.
Yeah, that's what Johan Reising. That's what Reising was saying, telling us the other day, that he doesn't really discuss patterns much with his students, because everybody, you know, the different ways to skin a cat, as they say.
Yeah, exactly. I think she's actually going for the side, yeah.
Yeah.
And I personally like that.
It's easier, that she option. Just pulls forward.
Yeah.
So she has the option of just drawing this back or studying off the rail, knowing that the 6 is right there, might just end up, well, she's stunning off the rail.
I just wonder what she's going to do with the 7 to the 8, because that's the next.
Naturally, she wants to be close to the 7 ball, but given her the angle she has.
Right now it looks like she's going to maybe just stop the ball. Well, no, she's falling through.
Because she wants to be close to the 7.
Yeah. I didn't know if she had the angle to follow through.
So now she'd be just option is
stop,
to draw?
Stop.
Well, maybe she needs to. Like now that. It's probably better off to draw back.
Yeah, for the side.
For the side, yeah. If she would have had a little angle, then, you know.
Well, she's not doing that, though. Well.
Nice to get close to her work.
Well, it's a preference, so.
Exactly, yeah.
You prefer the draw, she prefers the follow.
I think she's okay here. She has a little too much angle, though,
angle,
but
corner.
But it's still okay.
Play the corner, possibly play the 9 in the other corner, unless she can bring this to the long rail, come back out. That is steady. Straight on for the 9, stop shot for the 10.
You know, last night she was struggling in the middle of her match with Rubilin Ahmed, and then she steadied in the last rack. And perhaps the pressure is exactly what Chai Pei Chen needs to bring out the best in her.
10 ball, corner.
Chai Pei Chen of Chinese Taipei is on the hill and will be breaking for the match. That was a real test of character. She passed with flying colors. 8-7.
No.
This was a masterpiece here of Grace Under Pressure this last Friday.
Yeah, we are watching a really, really interesting match here. With lots of ups and downs and momentum swings.
Kai Young Kim won 3 of the first 4. And Chai Pei Chen 5 of the next 6.
Kai Young Kim 2. Leading 8-7.
Kai Young missed a 6 ball in rack number 13. Chai Pei Chen won that rack. Dai Young, the next one, Chai Pei Chen, this one to go on the hill.
What a journey for this young woman. On the brink, gets a ball.
Gets another ball.
Caught the second to the last qualifying slot just to break through. Of course, Ralph saying that, wondering why she was there in the first place.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
Nevertheless, had played more games than any other player left in this tournament.
And sometimes that's exactly what what happens, you know, when, especially on the women's side, I've seen so many players making it through qualifiers and ending up winning a big tournament. And that was a great shot here on the one ball.
Has she given herself too much angle on the two, though?
Well, maybe a little less angle she would have preferred, but I think it's still okay to kill the cue ball there. Played it with pocket speed very well here.
Well done, well done. This is deja vu all over again. This is exactly what we saw last night. Hill against Rubin and Amit. Amit breaks, doesn't make a ball, and never shoots again because Taipei Chen runs out.
I said it during the initial broadcast, Bob. I won't say it again right now. Not yet. I'll wait until she finishes that 10 ball. Because I did say something. You know, and if you feel it's time for you and it's your destiny, you know.
She's playing this track really well.
Yes, she is.
I might have wanted a little bit more angle on this 7, though.
No.
She's okay.
She's perfect. I think she actually wanted a little less angle to go 2 rails or maybe possible 3 rails. Because it's a little easier to go, you know, diagonal over the table than just go up and down. But
I obviously
don't know which way she wanted to go. But that was definitely the wrong way.
That's what I was saying. If she's a bit with a bit more angle, she can go up and down. Seems easier to me and probably would have been easier for her too. In hindsight.
That again is personal preference.
Yeah.
Well, she can still kick that ball in.
Tension.
8 ball is a little off the rail, so that gives her a bigger chance of actually making it. If she hits long rail, short rail first, and then, you know, the cue ball comes automatically out for position on the 9, but it's not an easy shot.
Oh, she got
it! Not an easy shot!
What a play!
What's that?
Rail first kick, 2-rail kick from Taipei Chen.
I'm speechless.
That's why. Two balls. I'll wait for it.
It's the 9 and...
That's going to be too
got
high.
Some work on the 10.
That's going to be too high.
Ten ball, right corner.
It's down. A break and run out, the first one of the match in the deciding rack. What a dramatic ending to an absorbing semifinal, and Taipei Chen has defeated Gaeyoung Kim 9 racks to 7. And we'll meet Kelly Fisher in the final. How about that, guys?